food to me means a lot more than just something you consume. It's spiritual, it brings people together. There's a community aspect. If you think of all your memories, more than likely it's around food. It brings people together, and I think there's just something really special in that. With my family, we always ate fresh ingredients, and that was something that I remember very vividly to this day.
At the beginning was the Gardens of Guanajuato and the little town where my mom is from. I think just going back to remembering where we came from, and that's something you shouldn't, like, we shouldn't forget about. I guess like eating that all the time or seeing it that people order that stuff makes me really happy because it's something that we grew up with.
El Pipila es un monumento en Guanajuato. Y le puse así porque yo quería algo que identificara que soy de Guanajuato, que soy de México. Y estar aquí en San Francisco, pues es una gran oportunidad para nosotros y para el negocio.
Everybody comes in and they say, do you sell burritos? And it's like, no, we do not have burritos. And yes, our pozole comes with bacon. And it was rated number 15 in February on a magazine called 7x7. It was 15 out of 100 restaurants in San Francisco, where we're really proud of.
Todo lo que cocinamos aquí es eso lo comemos en la casa, ¿no? Allá en Guanajuato y todo lo que cocinamos aquí lo comemos en la casa todavía. Es comida de casera para cuando vengan aquí al restaurante no piensen que están en un restaurante, piensen que están en casa.
I see sort of my spaces as a place for consciousness raising, that when people walk here in the door, maybe their worldview shifts just a little bit so that when they walk out those doors, maybe they approach life in a more equitable way. Maybe they think about something a little bit differently. This is an homage to my Arab culture as much as it is an homage to Oakland and the diversity here and the plethora of cultures. Like somebody walking in the door feeling the experience of love and hospitality, it's gonna come from workers who feel invested in a vision greater than just a bakery or just a restaurant. So both of my spaces are trying to do something bigger than just putting food on the table.
The food at Bonjour Kitchen is a food of my heritage. It's African American soul food, also based in Southern cuisine. You know, I love restaurants. I love creating the environment, and it's an opportunity to bring different people together, different backgrounds, so it really spoke to my interest in cultural diversity. Restaurant is this microcosm of the world, you know? It's just like this independently little operating business with, you know, little departments in it. We have people here that represent so many different continents and cultures from around the world.
My fear is having to prove myself to people, having to somewhat force them to move past the color aspect of things. As a server at certain tables, I run into that. Dealing with microaggressions and how people treat me at a table, that's something that I'm already experiencing now.
It's not a surprise that women of color are a minority in this field. On top of that, it takes money and capital to run restaurants, and unfortunately, We have to work 10 times harder to be seen as legitimate to funders in order to have access to capital to run our restaurants. And it's crazy, like, our white male counterparts can open and close restaurants and still get money.
San Francisco and the Bay Area in general is a very difficult food market. Lots of turnover, lots of businesses getting started and going out of business. And I think there's much more of a willingness to use technical assistance providers, to use one's community in some different ways to try and survive and thrive.
La Cocina is a nonprofit business incubator. We work with really talented working class women entrepreneurs, primarily women of color and immigrant women, who are launching, growing, and formalizing food businesses. The idea of the organization was that if those talented women entrepreneurs had access to opportunity and industry-specific technical assistance, that they could move their businesses from the informal economy, where they're making a little bit of money on the side, into the formal economy, where they're able to generate assets and change their communities for themselves.
I mean, the research basically shows that businesses and startups that touch incubation are, you know, 70% more likely to be around 5 years after they start up than businesses that are really trying to go on their own.
As a woman, it can be really hard to find people to follow you as well as a leader, because they're not used to seeing someone have the power or the vision you have. And no matter where we are in our career, we have to constantly prove ourselves over and over again. And our decision making gets questioned over and over again. And, you know, it's frustrating because our male counterparts, a lot of their decisions don't get questioned.
Over 50% of culinary school graduates are women, and still less than 25% of food businesses are owned by women. On average, in every part of the culinary industry, women generally make 73 cents on the dollar compared to a white man. Those statistics are even more stark when you account for race and immigration status, where black women are earning an average of 58 cents on the dollar, and Hispanic women or Latina women are averaging 53 cents on the dollar.
And the end goal of, you know, wanting to own a restaurant, wanting to do my own thing, would be finances. Having someone that's going to give you the capital, or getting the capital myself, systematically isn't there for black women.
The challenges that I see now versus maybe before is, I think you had larger communities of color, particularly in San Francisco, and they were the source of financing. Because oftentimes women and people of color can't access traditional sources of financing. They can't go to the bank. Some of that is because they're still new, and banks are not necessarily willing to give money to anybody who's new. But they may not also have some of the other networks that maybe men and or men of men who are white might have access to.
I care deeply about cities. They've always been places for strivers and for innovation, and that striving and innovation has often created even broader marketplaces, more ideas. When you block people out of the marketplace, you're limiting your capacity for innovation, you're limiting your capacity for growth.
I think small business of any sort is really important to communities. As a small business owner, it disturbs me to see, like, so many small businesses pushed out with all this development, you know, especially in the Bay Area with all the tech companies and this, you know, feeling of I'm not there, I don't have a support system. I feel for these women, and I think we need some more systems in place. There needs to be some reaching back to the community from the larger organizations that have those resources. They need to give back in that way.
The issue of gentrification is definitely, you know, something that's near and dear to me as someone who is really intentional about wanting social justice to be a core value of my restaurant. So every day we have to think about how do we make sure that we're not a gentrifying force, but that we're actually a force that gives back to the community. And so I make sure that I'm involved in the community and making sure that, like, that's coming back, you know, full circle.
When we started 5 years ago, the only women-owned restaurants were that I knew were from La Cocina, but as time went on, we started meeting way more women of color owned restaurants in San Francisco and as well as the East Bay or Bay Area.
I get the opportunity to provide a more nurturing environment and mentoring environment, primarily for a lot of the young women of color who work for me, but also young men of, you know, any background, women, anyone who feels like, you know, for some reason they weren't given a chance based on their age or, you know, maybe a past experience.
The newer waves of immigrants who are coming in, who, you know, because of the climate, the political climate, may be scared to talk about their culture, right? May not have the language skills.
It's just so ridiculous that the current administration is doesn't understand the value of, you know, what having immigrant populations can do for a country.
Community is everything. If you don't have a community, build your community. If you have a community, build a stronger community. Every time things have gotten tough, my community has had my back, and my success is just as much as their success as it is mine. And I always try to keep that in mind, that like it's not me alone that has done what I've done. So I think that keeps you humble, and it makes you build something a lot more beautiful than what you could have built on your own.
My goal at the moment is to create a project that is an intersection of food, art, culture, social justice, whether that's helping women of color in the restaurant industry, whether that's owning my own restaurant where you see all of those exhibited in the restaurant. I'm not really sure what that looks like, but that's something that's really important to me, is creating something that's for the community and by the community.
Tonight is evidence of what can happen when women are supported and given opportunities to dream and create. We'd like to thank Guadalupe Guerrero.
We get really emotional when we do this event. We've worked so hard, and it's for her dream, and it makes me really happy to be part of it.
And to work along my sister and my mom, it's a very hard job, but we've been managing to do it. One day it's going to be worth it, and that's one of the reasons we're working so hard for our dream to come true, and it's coming true. And I don't know if she wants to say something, but I know she's going to cry.
Pero thank you for coming, and gracias por la cocina. Están ustedes aquí con nosotros probando nuestra comida de Guanajuato. Muy, muy agradecida con todos. Gracias.
Thank you. You know, I think that's La Cocina's biggest impact is being able to expand the range of opportunity for people, not their capacity to execute on that opportunity, but legitimately what pathways are made available to them, what options they're given, and what flexibility they're given in trying to achieve their dreams. Certainly our hope is that we live in a place where opportunity is equitable. And in order to do that, not only do we have to give more to some people, but some people will have to give more up.
I think this whole notion of looking for the resources that are available and taking advantage of them is going to be absolutely critical if you're a startup venture, period, but particularly if you're a woman and or a person of color trying to enter the food industry. It's so competitive. And so you need to take advantage of those things that are particularly targeting the new ventures.
More and more people are understanding that women-run businesses also are valuable because they have social impact. I'm not the only one out there trying to really think about my business and the way that it can actually impact the community in a positive way. I think the best advice that I've ever been given that has helped me in my leadership, especially as a woman of color, because the stakes feel so high for us, is that having failure as an option opens up your options. As soon as I sort of had that possibility of failure, it opened up my avenues of possibility. And so that has really helped push me to kind of make bold decisions and be okay if they don't work out. Everything is a learning experience.
I could list many examples, you know, that I experience of just blatant sexism and racism. And, you know, I never know which one I'm being sort of judged by because, you know, it's integrated, it's intersectional for me. I've said very often to aspiring chefs and restaurateurs, especially, you know, women, talk to anyone who will listen and listen to anyone who will talk. I know a lot of young women now that are, you know, 10, 20, 30 years younger than me that are pursuing these careers with a vengeance, and they've had exposure to, you know, things I didn't, you know, this access to internet, different events, social media really helps, you know, people get their name out there. There's just so many opportunities to do research, and the resources are kind of endless now.
All of these, like, women of color within the restaurant industry are supporting each other, are, you know, doing collaborations. Reem is taking pictures with Tanya Holland, and seeing that from as something that I aspire to be, I think it's interesting because I want to know what it'll be like, you know, in 10 years if I'm still in the scene and if I, you know, have that, also that support from women of my age too. It needs to be collaborative. You need to support each other. It needs to be a community, because if it's not, it's not only for, like, yourself, you need that support, especially what we're saying, it's you have to work 10 times harder, and having that support of someone that knows what you're going through is really important. But I think also for the younger generation and having them see that it's possible.